Thanks for watching Pongcast TV, keeping you in the loop for all things table tennis. Make sure to subscribe to the YouTube channel, follow the show on Twitter, like the show on Facebook, and you'll be instantly updated whenever a new episode comes out. Welcome to Pongcast TV episode 22. Thank you so much for joining me. We're nearing the end of 2012, and most of the table tennis world is on a break until the new year. So in the meantime, we're doing a year in review, featuring some of the table tennis sightings and pop culture we've covered on previous episodes in 2012, plus the best shots, rallies, and everything in between. So let's get to it. On Pongcast TV, we've seen table tennis show up in some unexpected places, with some surprising fans and players that you may not have really known previously. That includes athletes in other sports, like former heavyweight boxers Vitali Klitschko and his brother Vladimir Klitschko. Vitali is quoted as saying in an interview that he plays every day with his brother and uses it to help with his reflexes. He also mentions playing helps him prepare for fights, and here he is playing with German national team member Christian Süss. We've also got F1 racer Nico Rosberg, who keeps up the pace off the racetrack and onto the table, and shows that he's actually got a pretty good game for a casual player. It looks like those reflexes behind the wheel also help him with the paddle. Also, here's NBA star Kevin Garnett hitting around with former world champion Wang Hao on Chinese television. And while many pro athletes play golf to unwind, what do golf players do? From what Phil Mickelson says here, it looks like table tennis is a popular choice. But it sounds like they are just as competitive on the course as on the table.
We've had a lot of fun together as teammates. I think we have had we've had not much success together on the course. But I will say that as partners on the Pong table, he and I are delivering. We are serving it up, and there are not many guys that can match us on the Pong table. So although we didn't play well together in 04 on the golf course, put us together on that table, and we're rocking it.
Plus, we've got Rory McIlroy hanging out with the former world number one German table tennis star Timo Boll and getting some pointers. Hollywood has also been getting into the act, spearheaded by none other than movie star Susan Sarandon. Of course, the owner of the famous spin franchise where table tennis clubs meet nightclubs. They've got locations in New York, Toronto, Milwaukee, and most recently just opened a new spot in LA. And on top of all that, she even produces and stars in a movie in the works revolving around the sport.
Looking into that's kind of like the Karate Kid with ping pong. But it would have to be done as a where people play and where, you know, it not like farcical, but very sweet. Because it is a sweet. The people who play ping pong are so weird and fabulous. And I have thought of that.
Is there a title?
Yeah, Ping Pong Summer.
Kunal Nayar from the hit show The Big Bang Theory talks about how the cast of the show is really into the game.
You are actually a very close cast.
We are.
How do you guys stay so close?
Well, we kissed. We play ping pong on the set. Actually, that's what really brought us together the first year. Actually, it brought us together, then tore us apart, because Kaylee and I are so competitive that we, on our second year, she's very good, and I'm Indian, so I'm good at racket sports, because any sport that has no contact, Indians are very good at.
Table tennis has found its way onto TV a few other times, including The Ellen DeGeneres Show. Ellen is also another well-known fan of the game and has included table tennis on her show quite a few times, including this appearance, where she invited U.S. Olympic team member Ariel Sheng to play against Matthew Perry.
Ariel, I played Ariel earlier today. I did pretty well, right, Ariel?
Yeah, she did really well.
Not really.
All right.
So then you can really play. You can really, told her to not do anything other than play the way she plays.
Oh, great. Okay. Go ahead.
It was also one of the pit stops on The Amazing Race, where contestants had to play against a junior player who used various objects to help even the field.
She's like, I'm going to play you with the paper side. I'm not even going to use the flat side.
Come on, James. It's got to be the 10-year-old. James, you got this. You got this.
So I got dusted with a clipboard. I just sit here and eat my piece of humble pie.
Table tennis is also a popular pastime for musicians who actually bring tables with them on the tours. From Justin Bieber to the band Lady Antebellum, whose members are quoted as saying they're simply obsessed with the game. Here's also a Korean music video that came out this year with a storyline revolving around the sport. It hasn't reached Gangnam Style numbers yet, but pretty cool nonetheless. And here's a very cool commercial in Sweden, one of the few countries where table tennis stars had a very high level of fame, especially in the 80s and 90s. Complete with some great special effects and a special appearance by Swedish table tennis legend and all-time great Jan Ove Waldner.
Som ni ser mina vänner, det mesta blir bättre med tiden.
And last, but certainly not least, 2012 was an election year here in the United States. Here's President Barack Obama, another fan of the game, playing with England's Prime Minister David Cameron. By the way, here's a butterfly table, complete with the campaign logo, some barriers, and ball trays, at Obama's campaign headquarters in Chicago. And as we all know, Obama eventually won re-election. Coincidence? And now let's move on to some of the amazing shots and rallies we've covered over the past year on Pongcast TV. We'll start with some great camera angle rallies, simply because with the low ground level angled camera shot, you can really appreciate simply how fast these players are, plus how low the margin of error really is on each shot.
كان ينتظر تغيير الاتجاه وتسديد ضرب
Up next are some marathon rallies. Because of the quick nature of the game, multiple shots are hit within just a few seconds, but here are some rallies that clocked in at 25 seconds or more, and you can sense the tension build with each moment.
رجعوا للطبيعة بقى المهاجم مهاجم ومدافع مدافع يعني بنت في منتهى الجمال مفيش اجمل من كده انا فضلت اللي عنده مشوار يروح يعمله ويجي ممكن يكون البونت لسه شغال خلاص كله مصر على انه ما يخسرش
هت...
Here's some great fake out shots that kept players guessing. And as always, lobbing rallies are great crowd pleasers.
And that ball came down with snow on it, so to speak, came back somehow onto the table. Very close in clipping the edge as well.
Too soon to win it. Too soon to win it.
Probably a big shock if his third game was 11-4.
Bastian Steger, der vor einer Woche zum zweiten Mal deutscher Meister im Einzel und im Doppel wurde. Das war der
Here's my favorite category that I call Slugfest. It's when two players are going all out, each person taking turns hitting the ball harder with each shot, and neither player backing down. It's like two heavyweight boxers who are trading punches until someone finally gets knocked out.
Go to the backhand side or the forehand side.
Hinter dem deutschen Meister.
Gerade mit so den.
But why waste all that effort when sometimes all you need is a good block? And here's the shouting match of the year between Achanta Sharath Kamal from India and Christian Suess from Germany, who let their voices be heard. In the end, Kamal came out with the upset.
13-11, game and match.
And finally, the best rallies of the year featured on Pongcast TV. I hope you all have a happy new year. And here's looking forward to another great year in table tennis in 2013.
好球，反手反拉，马龙继续侧，好的，哎呦！就是我们看到马龙在经过多板之后啊，在远台反手一个大发力，但是双方又形成了一个侧身对正手。
中远台，我们看到这个球特别。Oh,
that's an amazing shot! That's a ridiculous shot! Dave Weatherall falling to his right hand side, played a ridiculous forehand topspin, came wide, he just fell on the floor and he's cleared the edge! What a fantastic shot!
If you want to see any of these videos in their entirety, check out the show notes for this episode on my website at thepongcast.com. I'd love to hear your comments and ideas. You can follow and contact me on Twitter and Facebook, as well as email me at thepongcast@gmail.com. Thanks for watching.